हेलो स्टूडेंट, नाउ इट्स टाइम फॉर योर कॉमर्स क्लास. एंड यू नो दैट फ्रॉम योर प्लस वन कॉमर्स बुक यस्टरडे आई स्टार्टेड वन टॉपिक, नेम इज नेचर ऑफ बिजनेस. एंड अंडर नेचर ऑफ बिजनेस आई डिस्कस्ड विद यू व्हाट इज बिजनेस, फीचर्स, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ बिजनेस. सो बिजनेस सिंपली अ बिजनेस इज एन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी विच इन्वॉल्व रेगुलर ट्रांसफर एक्सचेंज ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज फॉर द प्राइस विद द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अर्निंग profits and acquiring the wealth through the satisfaction of human wants with an element of risk. So that's my today's topic is objectives of business. Let us understand the objectives of business. What are the business objectives? So the question is the profit the only objective of business? And the answer is no, because if that happens, then there are chances business can start doing unethical things just sake of the earning profits. Hence, it has necessary business has multiple objectives, like the human objectives, like national objective, like social objective, along with the economical objective. So, along with economic objective. So, in my today's lecture, the learning objective is business as an economic activity, aims or objectives of business. Under aims, objectives of business, today I will discuss with you economic objective, rest the human, national and the social objective in my next lecture. I will discuss with you along with the role of profit in the business and should the profit maximization be the goal of the business. So students, for your knowledge, the word objective means something that you are trying to achieve, whereas the business objective that a company aims to achieve. So every company decided in advance the goals or objectives for the company so that in future they work accordingly to achieve. So likewise, see one company, Tata Motors. Few facts about Tata Motors. Written Neville Tata, born 28 December 1937, is an industrialist and philanthropist and a former chairman of Tata Sons. He was also chairman of Tata Group from 1990 to 2012. And again as interim chairman from the October 2016 through the February 2017, and continues to head its charitable trust. Ratan Tata is the recipient of the two of the highest civilian awards. These two awards are the Padma Vibhushan 2008 and Padma Bhushan 2000. He is also known for his business ethics and philanthropy. And you know that the Ratan Tata Group pledged rupees 1500 crore in support of fight against the COVID-19 to the government. So, what are the business objective of Tata? Building excellence in buying and servicing process with an objective to improve the consumer perception for the product. Distribution and service network is strong, but focus is on improving the dealership to enhance the consumer experience in sales and services. Likewise, in case of Samsung, so students, the marketing objective of Samsung that the future of the electronic is inspiring the world and create the future. The objective of the company is to lead innovations in technology solution and product that inspire the communities all over the world to create a better world. So likewise, in case of McDonald's, very reputative company, McDonald's main aims are to serve good food in a friendly and fun environment, to be a socially responsible company and to provide good returns to its shareholder. The company aims to provide its customer with the good food of high quality, quick service and value for the money. Now, what are the key terms? Number one key term is business. Example, manufacturing business, fishing, mining. Like in case of the tractor manufacturing, the famous manufacturers are Mahindra Tractors, Swaraj Tractors and Sonalika. So students, the business refers to those economic activities which are connected with the regular production, purchase, sale or distribution of goods or services with the main objective of earning profits. Now the second term is diversification. Before the explanation, see the example. Like Johnson & Johnson, see the product line of Johnson & Johnson, Johnson baby product, second Avon, Neutrogena, Johnson clean and clear for skin care products, bandage, Cevalon and Neosporin for the wound care products, and the fourth one is Listerine for the oral care products. These all are the product line of the Johnson & Johnson. Now the meaning of diversification refers to the process of allocating capital in a way that reduces the exposure to any one risk. It is the act or practice of manufacturing and selling a variety of products so that a few failure in or any economic slump affecting one of them will not be disastrous. So it simply means that diversification, like one more good example of when the company or any business invested in different segments to earn more profits and loss of one segment when covered with the help of the profits of next segment is considered as diversification. Like in case of Godrej, you see that like previously Godrej main Almira is available, now edible products, biscuits also available, like hair colors also available. So the next term is Epsilon. The example of Epsilon, a simple mobile phone with keys and button was replaced with the touch screen. Likewise, a new car model with the few innovative features replaced the old one. So Epsilon means ki when your machinery outdated, something no longer used or become out of date. Now the fourth term is peer recognition. Example, it is as simple as one colleague expressing praise or appreciating to another. Peer recognition refers to the bona fide expression of appreciation between the co-workers. Now the next term is restrictive trade practices. Example, like which type of restrictive trade practices? Number one, exclusive dealing, full line forcing, tie and sales. Number one, exclusive dealing. What do you mean by exclusive dealing? Exclusive dealing refers to an arrangement whereby a retailer or the wholesaler is tied to purchase from a supplier on the understanding that no other distributor will be appointed or receive supplies in given area. In case of full line forcing, a business trade whereby a supplier encourages distribution retailers to stock or provide not only his principal product or services but additional other products or services from his range. And the third example is tie-in sales. Tie-in sales simply the sale of products to a customer on the expressly stated condition that a second product must be purchased. So these all three are the restricted trade practices. Now the meaning of trade practice here: delivery of goods or affects the flow of supply of goods or services in the market such a manner so as to impose unjustified cost on the consumer is considered as restrictive trade practices. And restriction is imposed by the government on the dealers not to do unethical practices. Now the next term is unfair trade practices. It consists of using the various deceptive, fraudulent or unethical methods to obtain the business through the misrepresentation, false advertising and other acts that are declared unlawful by the state. Business is an economic activity. My next topic is business is an economic activity. Why? Example here is workers working in a factory and receiving a wage is considered as economic activity. So simply means that when you are conducting the business for earning profits is considered as economic activity. So business is considered as an economic activity as it is undertaken for the purpose of earning money and livelihood and not for this psychological satisfaction. Profit which is earned through the business is essential for the survival and the growth of the business, and it must be earned through the legal and fair way without exploiting the society. So nowadays students, you know that you are successful only when firstly you satisfy the needs and wants of the consumer, then only it is possible for you to earn the profits. If you want to survive in the market, firstly satisfy the consumer, provide the products which are of good quality with reasonable price. See, a farmer cultivating crops for the family consumption is not a business. Yes, it is not a business because for family cultivating the crops, and but cultivation of crops for sales is involved in business activities because regularly or regularly basis this business the person the farmer sell the crops to the customers also and cultivating not for personal use for society. And the next part, see students, sale of premises early bought for the purpose of using it is not a business. For if you purchase any property, any land for personal use is not a business, but the property is bought and sold for commission on a regular basis like broker is considered as a business. Regularity of occurrence of business transaction is must. Now what are the objectives of business? Number one, first of all, what are the objectives? See, objectives are the end towards which activities of the business enterprise are directed. These are actually goals which are specifically established to guide the efforts of the business enterprise. A business enterprise may have many objectives, but profit earning is the most important or primary objective. So first of all, you know that the number of objectives available, economic objectives, human, social, and the last one is national objective. So firstly, in my today's lecture, I'm going to discuss with you economic objectives and see economic objectives, earning profit under objective. Economic objective number one point is earning profits, continuous innovation, optimum utilization of resourcing, and creating the customers. So my first point is all about creating the customer. And before that, what is the meaning of economic objectives? See, economic objectives, creating a customer and earning profit are the most important objective of the business. So business is basically an economic activity. So the primary objective is economic in nature. So economic means when you earn the profit after creating the customer, after satisfying the customers. Following are the economic objective of business. Number one is earning profits. The foremost and the primary objective of every business enterprise is to earn the profits, as without it a business cannot survive. You know that profit is the foremost objective of every business. If you want to survive in the business world, it is required to earn continuously a profit, otherwise it is quite difficult to survive in the business. So why profits and business required? So for growth it is required, for reputation, for expansion and diversification it is required. And see students, it serves as a barometer of efficiency, stability and progress of the business enterprise. So it is considered as a barometer for measuring the progress of the business. A losing business enterprise carries no goodwill. Higher profits provide economic power, which improves creditworthiness as well as bargaining strength of the business. You can also take the loans from the banks, from the lenders with the help of the profits. Your statement, financial statement, firstly they check out you are earning profits or not. Then only they provide you loans. So the next part, profit earning is necessary in business for the following reason. What are the reasons? Number one reason is profit is not only a reward for risk, but it also serves as a motivating force. So it motivates to the businessman to earn more and more profits also. It is necessary for existence of business. Yes, if you want to survive in the business world, it is required. The third point is it also measures the success of the business. You can easily measure the success of any company, any business with the full year profits. Now the fourth, profit provides an internal source of finance for the growth and development of business. So if you want to grow more, if you want to develop your business, you want to invest in some other branch of same name, so for this only profits required for investment purpose. Now the second point of economic objective is continuous innovation. And the example here is direct selling to the customer by removing the traditional distribution chain through the wholesaler. Retailer is the distribution innovation adopted by the Amway, Eureka, Forbes, Tupperware and other e-commerce sellers. You know that nowadays you are also using number of apps available. Like number one, Amazon, you are using Flipkart, you are using Home Shopping available, Napup available. So these all are the innovations in the commerce world. Change is inevitable and the business enterprise has to respond to such changes. It refers to development of newer methods of production and adoption of latest technology in production and newer ways of distribution. In today's world, it must for every business enterprise to make use of innovative ideas to win over the competitors through creativity and proper understanding of the consumers. Nowadays, if you want to survive in the business, you provide more innovative product as compared to competitors. And for competition purpose also, if you are not adopting the changes, then you are denying from the changes, then it is quite difficult for you to survive and to earn the profits in the market. Now the third point, according to the economic objectives, third point is optimum utilization of resources. So what is optimum utilization? You know that key resources very limited available, whether it is a man, finance, funds. So these goals can be achieved by reducing the wastages of material, maintaining and making full use of the machines, employing efficient people at a work, and recycling. And it refers to the best use of man, material, money and machinery. It is also considered as students for AMS. So it totally depend on the businessman how the person uses these all for AMS. The resources which are available to us are the scarce, and so these must be utilized in the best possible manner so that the business enterprise gets the maximum benefit from these resources. Now the next point from the topic economic objective is creating customers. So see students, creating customers, in the words of the Peter, there is only valid definition of business purpose to create a customer. You know that if you are not having customers who will purchase your products, how to earn the profits, how to earn the income. So the main point here is creating customers under economic objectives. So how to create a customers? Customers are created through the advertisements, sale and promotional activities. A business enterprise cannot survive unless there are customers to buy the products and services. So marketing strategies are to be formulated to create and retain the customers. Business can earn profits only when he or she provides quality goods and services at reasonable price. Business enterprise can survive for longer period only if has a substantial market share. So you know that nowadays number of companies providing number of schemes just to create the customers, like they are providing with product sachets free of cost, like with face wash, free creams available. So these all are the strategies of the companies to create the customers. Business enterprise can survive for a longer period only if has a substantial market share. So nowadays you know that number of companies available providing different schemes, like they are providing with product sachet free of cost, like with face wash they are providing free creams free of cost. So these all are the strategies of the business just to create the customers. Now these all are the students your economic objectives. Now in my tomorrow's lecture I will discuss with you the human, the next social and the national objectives. Now your homework questions, note down students. And isolated transaction does not constitute the business. Why? Second question, why business is considered as economic activity? State three reasons. What are the economic objectives of the business? Name them. And also refer this link, students, for more better understanding of the objective. Thank you.